हेलो फ्रेंड, नमस्कार। आई एम जेके। वी आर लकी टू हैव डॉक्टर के मोहन सर टुडे विद अस। आई हैव इनवाइटेड एंड रिक्वेस्टेड हिम टू शेयर हिज थॉट, लर्निंग्स एंड नॉलेज ऑन कंक्रीट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी विद अस। ही विल बी स्पीकिंग एंड टॉकिंग टू अस ऑन ए सीरीज ऑफ टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड टू कंक्रीट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। सो देयर विल बी ए होल सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर एंड टॉक बाय हिम। This is the first lecture of the series. Dr. K. Mohan sir needs no introduction. However, I will like to say a few words about him and his achievement. He is an internationally renowned and acclaimed cement scientist. He is a former Director General of National Council for Cement and Building Materials, NCCBM. He has a very vast and rich experience over 51 years in teaching, research, management, training, consultancy, technology development and transfer in cement and concrete science and technology in India and abroad. He holds a PhD degree in cement chemistry with the University of Aberdeen, Scotland, UK. He has carried out 8 years of original pathbreaking and pioneering research work at University of Aberdeen in the field of cement chemistry and technology under Professor H.F.W. Taylor. He is referred as a father of modern cement chemistry and Professor F.P. Glaser. He has 70 research publications in reputed national and international journals and 9 patents to his credit. His research and finding has been widely quoted in prestigious international journals and book on cement and concrete. He has widely traveled abroad and visited 15 countries in connection with his professional assignment. He has been an external examiner of many foreign and Indian universities. He is Bhish Pitama of cement chemistry. Now I would like to request Dr. K. Mohan sir to tell us about his introduction, about coming lecture and about concrete.
Thank you so much for inviting me to share my thoughts on different topics related to concrete science and technology. As you are aware, presently I am involved in teaching cement chemistry and concrete science and technology to students of a couple of prestigious universities as a visiting faculty. In one of the universities, I have designed a syllabus on cement chemistry for MSc Final Chemistry students, and I teach them cement chemistry. In another university, I teach the undergraduate and postgraduate engineering students concrete science and technology. The objectives of my making a series of educational videos on concrete science and technology are twofold. One is to create interest and awareness amongst engineering students about concrete, its science and technology. And the second is to share and pass on whatever little knowledge and learnings I have gained on cement and concrete science over the years, more than half a century, to young civil engineers and working professionals of construction industry. I do hope that they will be benefited by watching these educational videos, and that will give me immense satisfaction. This lecture series would be an important resource for students and budding concrete technologists. Well, now coming to the topic of concrete. Concrete is the most widely used material in the world after water. For thousands of years, concrete has been used for construction of landmark monuments. Over hundreds of years, concrete has become the material of choice for constructing residential and commercial buildings, infrastructural facilities such as highways, dams and bridges, canals, ports and other important facilities. The popularity of concrete owes to its economy, ability to be cast into any shape, ability to be fabricated practically anywhere, and last but not the least, its inherent durability. Innumerable historical monuments in concrete speak volumes about its durability and versatility. Concrete technology has progressed rapidly, especially since the 1950s. Thanks to the advancement of material science, today concrete is studied from an interdisciplinary viewpoint, where chemistry and material science occupy equally important positions as civil engineering. Another aspect that has led to the progress is the development of additives for concrete. These advances have ensured that concrete will be a material of choice for many decades into the future. Now, let us first understand what is concrete. Concrete is made up of four components, that is cement, fine aggregate, that is sand, coarse aggregate, that is gravels or crushed stones, and water. Cement is the most important ingredient of concrete, as it works as a binder and provides strength. The aggregates form skeleton matrix. It is about 70% to 75% by volume, 25% is a paste. Now, paste means cement and water that combines to form paste. 1% to 2% whites are usually there in normal concrete. But modern concretes are not only these four components, but it has two more components. These are admixtures, chemical admixture and mineral admixtures. Chemical admixtures, like some of them, are called accelerator, set retarders, water reducers, etc. These ones are added to the concrete system during production in order to improve the performance of concrete, either in fresh or in hardened state. Mineral admixture, that is the other kind of material, is goes into the concrete, sometimes even in cement making, and these are fly ash, silica fume, rice husk, ash, and other pozzolana or similar other material. We'll discuss about them later on in detail. So as we can see, modern concrete is not four component materials, but six components. Now there are a lot of advantages and disadvantages of concrete. A few advantages are, it is relatively a cheap material and it is used in very huge quantity for construction purpose. Next, it has a low life cycle cost. Now the life cycle cost means not only that initial capital cost is low, initial production cost is low, but its maintenance cost during service life period is also low. It can be molded, you can mold it into any shape that you like. It is robust. What it means is that it must have a sufficient resistance against life. It has got two weaknesses. One, it has got lower tensile strength, and other, it has got lower ductility. Now, ductility is a property by virtue of which the material exhibits a large amount of deformation prior to failure, and such large deformation ensures warning prior to failure. It does not fail suddenly. We have seen that cement is one of the main ingredients of concrete, other being aggregates and water. I have already talked about cement in detail in my series of video on cement chemistry, and the same can be watched for complete understanding of cement.